There are implications for a company's stock price as well. In the long term, majority of the companies that have instituted forced layoffs did not realize improved financial performance either on the balance sheet or on the stock exchange. So clearly, layoffs are not the only answer. But then, what are the alternatives? Let's look at the alternatives. Option number one is to reduce leadership or advanced level salaries. This is to ensure that all the lower level jobs in the organization are retained. Option two is utilization of paid leave. For many employees with overlapping telecommunication roles, employees can evaluate the use of leave or annual leave balance, and this allows employees to get paid as well as even keep their jobs. Option three is sabbatical. So if there is no annual leave balance, employees can go on a sabbatical until the situation improves. But even then, employees must continue to derive benefits from the insurance scheme and other benefits that are normally provided by the organization. For example, if these employees have signed up for the organization's PF scheme, the company must continue to make PF contributions during the sabbatical period. Option number four is work readjustment. Some roles have work that needs to be completed, but not at 100% utilization. And it's up to us to identify such roles. In which case, organizations can evaluate the option to reduce the working hours and thereby readjust the salary proportionately. In support of the option number one, I'd like to quote an example from hospitality giant Marriott International CEO Arne Morris Sorensen to retailer Macy's CEO Jeff Jennett and chairman of the Mahindra Group in India, Anand Mahindra, among other leaders who are letting go of their salaries for a set period and stepping up to impact any negative effect on the jobs.